back with me this morning from Alto Capital. Tony, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. A little bit of life coming back into the small end of the market, which is pleasing after a bit of a mid-year slump.
Plenty of life as far as news flow this morning here, Tony. Firstly, Eagle Mountain reporting significant resource expansion potential here at Western Talon. What's your take?
This looks fantastic. Looks as though they can, they're looking at high-grade multiple lodes to extend at 190 metres. So in the comments this morning, Tim Mason said that this could be a potential game changer at Oracle Ridge. So yeah, that continues the flow of great results and the consistent copper numbers. So looking forward to continued drilling, and they've been able to finally get some drill rigs happening and some assay turnarounds. So looking great for the medium term.
Also looking great here, Mako Gold continuing to deliver high-grade results in this morning here from Gogbala.
This is another great development. What they're saying is this is project is showing similarities to Chaga, which they're working on an initial resource. And what Mako are doing is delivering consistent high-grade numbers with some width. So this is another development in the growth to build a resource and become a serious gold company, because the market still isn't giving it much recognition. And we've been able to continue to accumulate stock. And these stocks do take some time to turn around, but once you get some momentum, it's looking fantastic. So kudos to the management team and having the cash to really hammer these projects.
Do you reckon the market's giving Alta Zinc much recognition here? They've put out this punchy exploration target at Gorno.
17 to 22 million tonnes potential, looking to develop this project into a tier one zinc opportunity. So the rallies in this stock are unsustainable. It had a bit of a run to 10 on the initial resource. It had another bit of a gallop into the mid eights, but there's just no follow through because the market and speculators want instant gratification, and they're not prepared to buy these juniors, I call wealth tokens, that have obvious paths to development and multiple upside. Because it's often what you don't know that continually can grow a company, because once you get one operation in a production, the growth opportunities open up. So again, both Mako and Alta are a bit sleepy at the moment, but we've had plenty of opportunities to build holdings. So no excuses at all from my clients.
Just away from natural resources here for a moment, Exopharm, another of your favourites here, announced yesterday the second commercial collaboration for its LEAP technology.
Yeah, Japanese company, Showerdenka, which is capped at 380 billion yen, I know that figure looks exciting, but that equates to about 4.7 billion Aussie. And they're researching the LEAP technology and purifying exosomes. There's only a small upfront payment of $10,000, $5,000 per month. And you are going to see some negative comments relative to that. But what Exopharm are looking to do is build these collaborations and license out that technology whilst developing their own medicines. So again, the stock has been in a bit of a nasty downtrend, which occurs, these stocks just break down, but looking forward to future news flow.
Right, Tony, you said at the start here, a bit of life returning to the market. How long will it last?
Well, it's hard to say. I guess you always need a return of the green-eyed monster. Greed, traders have had limited opportunities, but they're now jumping on anything, mainly the lithium stocks. And what I'm trying to reiterate to my clients is you are going to have order envy, where let's just say you're at a wedding and you end up with a dry chicken breast and the person next to you gets a perfectly cooked steak. And you just have to be patient in the fundamentally sound companies, not chase something, buy it at the top. And then as soon as it drops, that capital's pretty much dead. So I say to people, look, I do it the slow and boring way, but you end up still getting the multiple upside with less risk. So hopefully we are going to see a continuation of the trading. But, you know, the major indices are still tiptoeing through the tulips, as I like to call it. And I think we're probably due for a bit of a smackdown, bit of a correction. I think you just can't have markets drifting sideways like this. And there's still a lot of bad news coming out surrounding COVID. Our economy is looking weak. And the RBA made a comment that then that looks as though they're not going to lift interest rates to 2024. And that's showing that the economy needs some help. It is going to be weak. But I still think that interest rates probably will increase before that time.
Good to see you, Tony. Thanks very much.
Absolute pleasure, Andrew. I look forward to the next instalment.